Attackers have been installing malware on Microsoft Exchange servers after the servers are exploited so the attackers can continue to access them. The Microsoft Safety Scanner, which I'll refer to in this video as MSERT, or the scanner, looks for these known malware files, including web shells, and removes them. A web shell is a piece of malicious code, usually a web page, that an attacker can install in your web server to remotely control it. I'll walk you through the process of downloading the scanner and running it in a couple of different ways in order to remove any known web shells that may be on it. It's important to note that the scanner is regularly updated to detect some new malware. If you run it several times over multiple days, then you should always download the latest version and not reuse the one that you already downloaded. As such, the version you see in this video will likely be different than the one you downloaded, and that's expected. Also, the scanner will not look for the Exchange exploits themselves, just what files an attacker drop after the exploitation has already occurred. First, make sure you're on the Exchange server you want to scan, open a web browser, and go to the Safety Scanner download page. A link to this page will be included in the description for this video. Click on Microsoft Safety Scanner 64-bit and click Save. You will need to run the scanner with administrative permissions, so open the folder and double-click on the MSERT file if you're already running as an administrator. If you're not logged in as an admin, then right-click and go to Run as Administrator. And the Windows may prompt you to enter in admin credentials. Review and accept the license agreement. And then note that the MSERT tool is not a replacement for a regular anti-malware solution. And then click Next. For your first time running the scanner, choose a quick scan. It will look at the most commonly used directories for malware, including the common directories that your server uses to host web pages that can also hold the attacker's web shells. Click Next, and the scan will start. And then you'll see a progress bar, what files the scanner is currently looking at, the total number of files scanned, the total number of files that it's found that are infected. Now the quick scan will take a few minutes, so we'll fast forward the video a little bit to skip some of the waiting. We see the scanner found one infected file. Now the video will skip to the end. With the scan we just performed, you can see that it detected malware and that the malware was removed. The icon is a yellow shield with an exclamation point. Click View Detailed Results on the scan to see what was found. Under Malware, it shows the type, in this case, Backdoor ASP Chopper, with the scan results saying that it was removed. Click OK, and then Finished. If the scan completes and no malware was found, then the window after the scan will show a green shield with a check mark. If the scanner does not find a web shell and you believe the server was compromised based on the output from running test proxy logon, then we recommend running a full scan next. A full scan may take hours or days to complete, depending on the system, so plan accordingly. Reopen MSERT. Accept the license and click through the welcome screen. And then select full scan. The output of the full scan will be the same as the quick scan, depending on if malware was found or not. After the scans are completed, consider installing an antivirus or anti-malware solution on the system. See the video in the series on how to install Microsoft Defender for Endpoint as a prevention from attackers installing web shells in the future. If MSERT found a web shell or other malicious files, see the customer guidance on remediation steps for further instructions. A link to this documentation will also be included in the video description.